Christmas, everyone. It is Christmas morning. I just got through, of course, you know I'm cooking my gumbo, and I just got through adding water, just water, to my gumbo pot, which I put it about right here. So much water in there, because how big the pot is. So a little over halfway. I have my sausage here. And I'm not going to season my sausage because this is seasoned sausage. Sausage is considered as hot. It's hot. This is hot sausage here that I got from Louisiana with garlic inside of these. Can you see this? It looks good. It's not even cooked, right? And over here, I have my chicken, which I already seasoned yesterday, so I just pour it in here in my pan. Have my oven on 350. I have my, I'm gonna turn the fire up. I need to go ahead while the water is just water. While the water is still cold, before it get hot, I need to put my root in there. And that root is something that I have already made. I've already made my root because when I cook, I always, let me see, where's that? Oh, my root, I'm putting my root in. See this? This gum gonna cook, I don't know how long, many hours. I'm thinking no more than about 3 hours. So I need to, of course, I need to put my root in. I need to put my root in while the water is still cold, because then you don't want to put no root in while the water is hot, because it's going to clog up. So I'm just going to pour it. Ask me how much. I don't, well, it depends. Because you can always come back and add more root. So my root in there, I'm going to stir it up. And again, you need to put it while your water is still cold, because when it's getting, when it's hot, then it's gonna clog up. So I need to go get me a big utensil that I don't have. So I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. All right, I need to get my turkey necks and get them together and put them inside here. So hold on. All right, I just heard my oven says it is ready for me to put in my chicken, and I can't do it holding with one hand. So that's my sausage and my chicken, and I'm about to put it inside the oven. Again, I have my sausage and my chicken in the oven. My sausage is already cut up, washed and clean last night, and my chicken is already cut up, washed and clean. I'm not gonna cover them up. The reason why I'm baking my chicken and my sausage, because I'm not going to put my chicken inside of my gumbo yet, because I want to bake my chicken and sausage. And once it's cooked, I want to drain that grease. I don't want any grease inside my gumbo. Like a lot of times back in the days, people used to put this food in their gumbo, and their gumbo would be so doggone greasy, and they would have to skim the grease off of it. So when you look at this big piece, and that's my smoked turkey necks. When you bake, turkey don't have much grease. First of all, that's why I use turkey. And it's smoked turkey necks. And I only use half, fill up the pot up halfway, is because by the time you add all this meat in here, it's going to be towards the top. So this should be ready by 12. That's giving me 5 hours. Yes. Had to use my fingers to count. So again, this is only smoked turkey necks. Some people, you can really use anything you want to in your gumbo. That's your choice. That's your gumbo. Back in the days when I was a little girl, my mama and them, I know my daddy, he loved his hen. Hen in the gumbo, which you can. People put hens, and of course my daddy liked to have some rooster. He wanted some rooster in his gumbo. And when you use meat like that, hen, rooster, turkey necks and stuff, you don't have to worry about your gumbo breaking up. I mean, not gumbo, your meat breaking up. A lot of times people use chicken and gumbo, and by the time the gumbo ready, the chicken and that all fell a piece. They're in pieces and strips. But when you use turkey necks, or if you bake your chicken first, and then once your gumbo is ready and your chicken is done, you can just drop your chicken inside your gumbo. You're not putting any grease in there, and your chicken won't fall apart. So if you're going to use chicken, bake your chicken, cook your chicken, air fry your chicken. I don't care how you do your chicken, but do it on the side. Don't put your chicken inside the gumbo when you first cook in the gumbo, because your chicken will fall a piece and you'll have nothing but bones to the bottom and strips of chicken, pieces of chicken on top. That's just a note to the wise, but hey, that's your gumbo. You can cook your gumbo how you want to. I'm just telling you how I do it. And then also, too, you won't have all that grease inside your gumbo. If you want to have a greaseless gumbo, first you have to start with the root, like I did. Let's go back to it again. This is dry root. I make my own root, which is nothing but flour and seasoning. Either you can have it baked. I even did if you look at my videos, you'll see a video where I cook root in a slow cooker. I didn't realize you can cook root in a slow cooker too. So when I found that out, it was on like a chicken bone. Now it take maybe a day or two, because you have to cook the root on low. But you can cook root in a crock pot. You need to check that video out. Me cooking root in a crock pot. Now I might eventually use all this root, but I have to first wait and see. And you can see, let me look inside here, this is the color my gumbo would be.